Hello and welcome everyone. The question from organic chemistry are from Cladden chapter number 6, that is from nucleophilic addition reactions. Draw the mechanism for the following reactions. The reactions are given here. In the first box, a cyclobutanone is given that reacts with the reagent sodium borohydride in combination with ethanol in water, that gives the product is cyclobutanol, from cyclobutanone to cyclobutanol. In the second reaction, so this is cyclopentane carbaldehyde is given, that is this is a 5-membered ring and aldehyde group is attached to that. When treated with the lithium aluminum hydride in combination with the THF as a solvent, it gives the product is an alcohol. So it is an example of nucleophilic addition reaction via the hydride ion transfer. So let me first introduce what is that hydride ion transfer. So any carbonyl compound when treated with the metal hydride complex, what happened to that? So metal hydride complexes are the just like organometallic compound. So why? Because of they have the negative charge on the hydrogen and the metals bear the positive charge. So similar to that of organometallic compounds, hydrogen ion, that is hydride ion, via it's a sigma electron, it act as a source of nucleophile and it is react with the sp2 hybridized carbonyl carbon, which is electrophilic in nature. So the bond will be open to that oxygen. So in first step, it will get the tetrahydral intermediate like this, and here the simple reaction is called as this one. This is called as a nucleophilic addition reaction. In the second step, we are using a aqueous solvent, like example water, as for acidic workup, and it converts that compound into the stable one. So you will get this product. So this type of a reaction is called as nucleophilic addition reaction. Okay, so in these two above reactions, the two reagents are given to you. In first reaction, sodium borohydride. In second reaction, lithium aluminum hydride. So if you compare that these two, that is sodium borohydride and lithium aluminum hydride, so among these two, LAH, that is lithium aluminum hydride, is more reactive reagent. So this one is more reactive and less selective, one can call it as a less selective. Similarly, for sodium borohydride, it is what? It is less reactive and more selective. So I will give the first simple example of this transformation, how one can identify the NaBH4 or LAH, which is a more efficient. Say example, I have a two functional groups are present in our molecule, say example this, okay, and in that molecule when I treated with this two specific reagent, that is NaBH4 and LiAlH4. So sodium borohydride can be used in protic solvent like ethanol, but LAH cannot be used in aqueous solvent like ethanol or water, so always use the dry ether condition. Now in this molecule there are two function groups are there, one is nitro group and second is a carbonyl group. So LAH is a more reactive reagent, so it is less selective, so it reduces both the functional groups. That means it reduces your carbonyl group to alcohol and nitro group to amine. While in case of what your this molecule NaBH4 only reduces the carbonyl group, this NO2 is intact. So your product will be like this and NO2 will be intact now. So this type of what reactions are called chemoselective reaction. What are the chemoselective reaction? So whenever your reagent selectively reacts with one of the functional group from the molecule, that type of reactions are called chemoselective reactions. So where it preferentially attacks to one of the functional group and remaining functional group is intact or inert. That's why sodium borohydride is a selective reagent compared with lithium aluminum hydride. Why it is so now? Because in lithium aluminum hydride, both the metals are more reactive, that is lithium as well as the aluminum. But in case of sodium borohydride, the only sodium is more reactive and boron is what belongs to that P block family. And you know the chemistry of P block. So that's why LAH, that is lithium aluminum hydride, is one of the versatile reagent. You know that versatile means it reduces most of the functional groups from organic molecules. And simply NaBH4 only for aldehydes as well as ketone. Okay, remember this point. Now, as per our question is asked, so simple mechanism, we will see the mechanism of this one. So I have this molecule and when I treat it with sodium borohydride. Now, what is the structure of sodium borohydride? You know that borohydride like this one. Okay, this is actual structure of sodium borohydride and here like this one. So sodium tetrahydridoborate, this is the name of this compound, and you know that each BH bond is ionic in character, so it will transfer the electron density via from sigma bond. So here the electron density should be transferred from here to here, the bond will be open to what? Oxygen. Okay, you will get the intermediate, that is tetrahydral intermediate. Okay, so look at this one. So this will be the O negative and here the hydrogen will be there, which is coming from your reagent. And remaining you can mention here, so your remaining will be here. So this will be your B H H H like that. Okay, so it can develop like this type of the bond now. So appeared now, or this is what you get in the first step. And after that, what happened? That O negative, okay, O negative will take the proton from, say, example, water. So I have suppose an water molecule at here now. That O negative will take that hydrogen and it will be converts to the neutral product like this. So this hydrogen is coming from your reagent and this hydrogen is coming from your solute or simple water one can say. So this is simple reduction reaction and that mechanism is called as nucleophilic addition reaction. This is called as a nucleophilic addition reaction. You must classify the reaction. Okay, so let's move to the next example from your question. So given the example is cyclopentane, this is cyclopentane and aldehyde group is there. This is called as a cyclopentane carbaldehyde. When this molecule is reacts with aluminium lithium aluminium hydride, so I will draw the structure first here. Again the same chemistry, but the difference is that ALH bond is more polar, more ionic, more reactive than BH bond. So here the same concept is there. The electron density from that ALH bond will be like this one. You will open the bond and after that opening of the bond you will get the structure that is tetrahydral intermediate. So look at this, and here this will be the O negative and here your H from your reagent. And later on you know that same what happened here. So that alkoxide ion, this is actually what alkoxide ion, that is intermediate, it treated with your water here HOH. Must remember, so the water should be added in the second step, not in the first step. What happened when you add water in the first step? Your reagent becomes completely destroyed now. Okay, and to So then you cannot use that reagent. That's why water should be added in the second step. And finally, what happened? So you will get the product. That reduced product will be obtained now. This will be the OH. Okay. This will be the H, and here will be the H. Now you can see that. So the hydrogen which are added, yellow colored hydrogen added from reagent, and that orange one, it's from particularly the water. So this is very simple and interesting example. So one can say particularly the mechanism using the BH4 anion and AlH4 anion. Okay, so the if we compare the reactivity order, the LH will be the faster one, which undergo the faster nucleophilic addition rather than what the BH4. So remember this thing. This is very simple example of nucleophilic addition reaction. And the question is from chapter number 6, from the book, best book of organic chemistry, that is Claydon. So I hope you get the concept of what nucleophilic addition reaction. Remember one thing, in nucleophilic addition reaction, first there is addition of nucleophile onto the electrophilic carbon. This is what? Electrophilic carbon. Okay. There is a formation of what? So look at this carbon now. This is sp2 hybridized carbon, which converts to sp3 hybridized carbon, and that is simply the alkoxide. And after protonation, you will get the alcohol is the product. So it is also sp3 hybridized. So from sp2 to sp3, there is a change in symmetry, there is a change in all the stereochemical aspects of that molecule. So remember this one. So first step is nucleophilic addition. Second step is what? Addition of what? Simple abstraction of the proton by using water, etc., etc. So this is what called a nucleophilic addition reaction. So thank you for watching this one. Stay safe and stay connected.